At one of our remote sales and rentals locations, our office was vandalized and burnt down. Here's what's left of it. Unfortunately, our office housed our power meter and our electrical service. So now I am without power on the entire site. It is cold outside and I need to plug in my forklifts. I'm gonna show you in this video another option. This is a steel shipping container. Can be used as an e-house. And as a bonus, I'm gonna show you two more things in this video. We actually have some prototypes installed here. We got a cable gland pass-through frame that we're gonna utilize to poke extension cords through, and our Big Air solar vent. This thing is mint. I've had this design for a long time, and I don't know why I've been procrastinating releasing this, but you're gonna enjoy it, so stay tuned. Hope you learned something. We're gonna build our entire electrical service here in Saskatoon, in our shop, and ship that to our other location and commission this thing. This is fireproof. This is a steel shipping container that can no longer light up, and it should last the test of time over at that site where it's rough and tough. E-houses such as this are becoming a very common solution. We actually build some of these and rent them out. So a lot of construction sites want temporary power, and they're a great solution for that. They got fork pockets, they can move all around the site, and our local utility provider can actually roll in and give a permanent power with a meter to a temporary site. This works well, especially when they're at universities or hospitals and you're doing like a 2 or 3 year long construction project. You now can control your power. You're not renting plugs off the neighbor. So it's a great solution for that. But a regular container is not the best solution as is. It needs to be paired with Container Modification World's modular strut system brackets. These exterior strut brackets allow us to strut line vertically, and then we can ladder across, and now we can install anything. So we got our loop box and our meter box, and we can also strap our conduit down for our ground cable and then the power service coming into this thing. So this here works great on the outside of the container, and we can mimic this process inside the container with the interior strut brackets. And inside of here, same goes with our modular strut systems. We're able to install these MSS single brackets down low and up high, and that gives us vertical struts. We have them on every outside corrugation on the end wall here, and we also ran 4 of them across the ceiling. That allows us to have a motion sensor to kick on this 4-foot LED light. And so inside this panel here, we got 3 different 20 amp breakers feeding each one of these boxes. So we're gonna be able to plug in lots of diesel equipment there and get our operation up and running. We can now build off of this surface mounted electrical system. So if additional stuff was needed inside of here, it's super easy for any electrician, even if it's another electrician, to roll in and just start piping out of here. And if this was a larger shipping container, if we needed more space for whether it's an office storage combo or some inventory storage of our mod components, we can also then pipe out and run electrical to an entire 40, 53 foot container. This is the best way, in my opinion, to do electrical. Get your strut installed first and then call your electricians. They can show up and just get rolling. So now that you've seen how we can strut line this thing inside and outside, if you're looking to do something like this yourself, you can actually do this strut framing yourselves. And then when your electrician rolls in and he sees strut channel, he will be right at home. So let's check out these prototypes here. We got our cable gland protrusion frame, we call it. These things are really cool. It's pretty much an addition to our vent line. It's a similar concept in the profile that we developed, but there's this 4-inch hole here, and these rubber glands, they can have all different trade sizes of openings. So here we just got a real small one. We're gonna be able to poke 1, 2, maybe 3 extension cords out there, and that's gonna be able to plug in our equipment at site there. So until we get another office up and rolling, we can just run cords out here, and the most someone's gonna be able to steal from us is the extension cord itself, but they're not gonna be able to vandalize, I don't know, the electrical box or anything on the inside. So we figure that's a pretty cool idea. A lot of times in other e-houses, we've seen people just legit leave an open hole in the side of the container for running cords out of. This being able to self-heal around that cord is going to keep it more weather tight. Another thing I wanna show you is how we keep all that electrical nice and dry. So condensation happens inside of shipping containers. That's a known fact. These new containers painted white, they won't attract so much heat, so they might not condensate as much, but electricity inside of here will generate some heat. If it's super cold outside, that's gonna turn into condensation, some frost, and that's gonna collect all in the ceiling of these things. And that's gonna drip down on our electrical, and we don't want that to happen. So one way to mimic that is to ensure air is moving throughout this thing. And we can do that with vents. So just 2 passive vents would be good enough, but because this is our own container, it's a great opportunity to try out our Big Air solar vent. So these things are awesome. They got a 5-volt solar panel on them, which runs the 5-volt axial fan. So there's a fan on the other side of this on the interior shroud, And that just is constantly circulating 54 CFM of air when the sun is ripping on this solar panel. When it isn't, it still acts as a passive vent. So it still can ventilate throughout the nighttime, but usually most of your heat problems is gonna happen when the sun's beating on your container. So if you can ensure that that is installed on a south-facing side of your container in the northern hemisphere, then that is going to definitely help ensure that you have just constant, a certain amount of airflow circulating through your container, and you still have the passive benefits at night. I'm not certain fully if we're gonna install a intake vent that matches that size at the beginning. What I really wanna do is just send this thing outside for a couple of days and see how much air I can feel through these stock container vents, because there's a few of them in there. They only ventilate, I don't know, the size of a nickel, so they don't do a lot. They're more meant for depressurization of this thing, but there's typically only two of them on a 40-foot shipping container. This is a 9-foot container, and it's got, I think, at least four of them. So they could act as the intake for it. I'm going to be able to see that right shortly here, but what's strongly advised is potentially two BigAir 45s or two BigAir 30s, so that those two vents for sure are passive ventilating. And then when the sun is beating on your potentially dark colored shipping container, and especially down in desert areas, really make sure you get some active ventilation as well. So if you're interested in power, you're probably interested in water. And thankfully, Giraffe Tools sent us a free product to show you guys. And this thing I can stand behind. This thing is awesome. It is a pressure washer that mounts to the wall. It has a retractable reel, and it's a 100-foot long hose. So this thing allows us to wash all of our shipping containers prior to starting all of our modifications, and it has torque. I am not joking. I had two other electric pressure washers, and when you're plugging into just a 15 amp circuit, you do not get that car wash level of pressure. And check this thing out here. Listen to that thing. That thing has torque. So I love having this ability to actually just clean our container spotless before we start all of our modifications. I always joke to my friends when they ask me what I do, I say I'm a part-time pigeon farmer, because holy, do those things ever like to live in between the shipping containers. It's the reason we developed our pest plug product line, is because of all the pigeons crapping all over the sides of our shipping containers, and that drips all the way down, and that stuff is like acidic and it is gross and it's hard to get off. And previous pressure washers that we've had didn't do the trick, but this thing, we have a hot water line running to it. We don't need to use soap or nothing. It just makes these things sparkle.
Woo, I love this thing. This thing is amazing. I can't believe how well it worked, and I really want one at home. And I think if I would have had this at Lloyd, I would have been able to put that entire office out. She's got so much power. So if you enjoyed this video, please help us out and give it a like. If you'd like to see more cool container modification projects, we've got some really cool innovative infrastructure stuff coming up this summer. Subscribe to the channel and ring that notification bell. And as always, check us out at tcg.ca. Hope you learned something.